Hello friends, welcome back again, and let's continue the creational design pattern, factory pattern session with the remaining programs and interview questions. So let's get to the programs which is based on the domain. So I have a couple of examples which is based on the different domains of banking domain, employee management, e-commerce and recruitment. So let's understand very basic way. So banking account management, so I have a very base interface which is a type banking account. It has certain abstract methods, so create account, money in and money out. Now if I have to create a saving account, so I have this basic interface defined and I am creating a saving account, or I have another class which will use the very basic interface and create an object of type current account. So domain wise example, so I have a very basic class and I want to create a saving account or current account, and I have a factory which will create the objects for me when I call the methods or when I want to use a particular type of object. So let's see this banking account, three methods: create account, money in, money out. And saving account has its own implementation and with some couple of variables. So create account, so this is an implementation way for saving account. So it will have a first name, last name, balance amount and daily transaction limit, etc. Money in, money out, so some implementation. Daily transaction limit is 2, so it will just compare some values, and money out. Okay, now let's see implementation of type current account. So banking account, current account. So again, transaction limit is 100. There may be different clauses, there may be different types in which you can implement the current account. So create account, money in and money out. Okay, now I have this factory class which is getting rid of all the internal implementation of different type of derived classes, or this current account and saving account. So what I need to do in my program is to use the factory for bank account, this factory class, and just pass the parameters what I want and get the job done. So in my final example 10, I'm creating a factory object for type factory for bank account, and I'm just calling the get bank account of type saving or of type current. So, so finally I'll get an object which is of type very basic, called basic account, and I'm just passing the parameter. So create account, money in, money out, create account, money in, money out. So let's see what is the output. So initialize account with the following type, so first name, last name and initial balance and all, money in, money out, daily transaction limit exceeded. So this is the this is the beauty in which you will see that for basic account, for saving account there is a transaction limit, and if there is a current account, so now I'm creating another class, another object of type current account here, and so I can call number of methods. So although I'm calling similar methods, but if you see, there is no daily transaction limit, or so that is a difference in the earlier example and this example, where I can see the output as a for a particular domain. Now let us see for employee management. So I have an interface called employee management, create employee, process salary. So I have a class which implements this basic class of employment, but for type employment type permanent and employment type contract. So let us see what is the difference. So create employee and process salary. So if you see, I have this implementation for create employee and process salary for type permanent employee. And for type of contract, if you see, the difference is So if you see the salary calculation, so salary calculation, if you see transport allowance and government pension is added, but for employee of type contract, there's nothing like that. So just it will deduct the tax. Now I have this factory class which is creating a factory of objects, and it will return me just object of type intended. So if I want permanent or contract, that's all, it will give me an object. So in my final example, example 1.1, I am creating a factory object and factory class object, and which will allow me to create object of type permanent or contract. I am assigning it to E1 and E2 and just create employee and process salary. Now if you see the output, initialize the account with following details. So permanent employee, contract employee, salary process for permanent employee will be this, and salary process for contract employee will be this. So if you see in the contract employee section, the only the tax deduction is happening, and in the permanent employee section, government pension and so additional details are getting introduced. E-commerce type. So in e-commerce example, I have a product activity interface which is having methods, abstract methods, show product, add to cart. So product activity on PDP, product activity on PLP. So if you go to any e-commerce website, so PDP is product display page. So where you will see, so if you navigate and if you search for some product and it will show a display, so that is called product listing page, where all the products related to that particular term will be shown in single page. And if you click on an individual product, it will navigate to another page and it will show you a single object or single product. Single product is PDP, product display page. Product listing page is multiple products. So product activity, show product, add to cart. So in both the functionality, that is PDP and PLP, we have show product and add to cart methods. So PDP, individual product display page, which is implementing product activity, the very base class, the very base interface, and it has certain methods, certain variables. And show product has this implementation, add to cart, it has this implementation. Product listing page, show product and add to cart. So the difference is from which place we say show product and we say add to cart. Again, I have a factory class which will create a factory of different type of objects which I want, and I need not to bother about earlier implementation of what are the types of objects I need to implement and all the stuff. Coming to my example, example 1.2, so I'm just creating an object of this factory class, and using this I am passing the intended object type to this product activity P1 object P2, and I'm just calling the method called show product add to cart, show product add to cart. Now let us see the output. So initialize account with following details and final amount after adding to the cart. Showing product with following details. Final amount after adding product to the cart. So this is another example of factory pattern. The last example would be recruitment. So similarly, very quickly, I have a very basic class called job post and internal forum and external forum. So internal means, let's say this is within company, and external forum is like on a particular job site or some additional forum which is external to the company. So I have individual implementation for show job details and how to apply. So let's just run this directly and see the output. So showing job post with following details. So automation architect, some job requirement details, and skills required and the salary. Showing job post with following details, internal referral. So as we see, if you do it in internal forum, we have a internal referral award with some cash prize. Send resume to a particular email ID. Now, if you post it, if you do it using external forum, in the external forum, the showing is different. So it is showing some expiry date and it is not showing the referral bonus, but because the referral award, because that is not for the external hire or for external forum. So both implementations are a little different, yet we can do it using single factory class. Now let us get back to interview questions. So difference between factory and abstract factory design pattern. So abstract factory design pattern is also another design pattern. So factory pattern deals with creation of objects delegated to a separate factory class, whereas abstract factory patterns work around a super factory which creates other factories. Difference between factory and builder design pattern. So builder design pattern is also one of the design pattern in Java. Builder pattern is the extension of factory pattern, wherein the builder class builds a complex object in multiple steps. Difference between factory and strategy design pattern, which is also a design pattern called strategy design pattern. Factory is a creational design pattern, whereas strategy is behavioral design pattern. Factory revolves around creation of objects at runtime, whereas strategy or policy design pattern revolves around the decision at the runtime. Let's continue this session in the next video series. For more exciting videos, please like, comment, and share my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.